Hello and welcome to the 4th of December, the 4th day of Advent here in Advent in Britt Arnhild's world. I'm Britt Arnhild and I'm coming to you from the middle of Norway, the city of Trondheim. Welcome to new viewers and welcome back to all of you who come back every day during this period. Today I want to talk a little about angels. You saw the film in the beginning about the making of these angels. You have seen these angels in all episodes, I think. And I share with you the angel tales. I will share with you another tale today also. It was almost by coincidence that I started to make these angels. I collect nativities, and some years ago I knitted a nativity, and I have been thinking that maybe this year I shall crochet one. And I had this leftover yarn, and I started to crochet two angels, these two. This yarn was not the perfect yarn to make a high angel like this, because if I try to make it stand, it falls down very easily. So I went over to make more from Rauma Finul, which is a better yarn for this purpose. But still, it was a little difficult. If I put them on the table, they would easily fall over. My husband, he is a handyman with capital letters. He can do everything. And he has, his father was a carpenter. And he used to help his father from he was a tiny little boy. And he still loves to be down in our basement where he has his own workshop. And he makes things, a lot of beautiful things. And he also is a problem solver. So every time I have a practical problem, I can just ask him and he solves it almost immediately. And I said, oh, Terje, these angels, I want them to stand, but I have no idea how to do it. Can you help me? And it didn't take long. He said, yes, I have this... And here I lack the English word, but these long sticks to hold a brush or garden things to work with in the garden. And they had broken into two. And Terje is a man who never throws away anything which might be useful one day. And of course, two broken long sticks like this might be useful one day. And it came useful. He said, I have these wooden sticks. Maybe I can cut them up in the perfect size for you. And we can put them into your angels. So that's what he did. He had to make a quite long one for this, because it really too easily fell down. But for all the other angels, he just made shorter ones, just like this. You see, it's dirty. It has been used for years and years and years in the garden and in the yard. And now it is used to hold angels. And I was able to go down in the basement and make a film for you while he worked on this. Isn't that quite cute? In our house, for Christmas and during Advent leading up to Christmas, I decorate more every day. But we don't have any Santa Clauses here in our house. It's not that I don't like them or anything like this, but I have so many angels. I have so many nativities. I have so many other things that I haven't quite found a room for the Santas. In Norway we have the Santa, which is inspired originally from Saint Nicholas, and then from the American Santa Claus. But we also have the Norwegian Nisse, which might be translated into English with the word gnome, I think. But we use the same word for the Santa Claus and the gnome, the Nisse. Nisse is the Norwegian word for both of them. So we kind of mix them up. And there are so many beautiful Norwegian Nisse to use as decorations and so on. So who knows? Maybe I will do something. Maybe I will even make Advent episodes 1 year about the Norwegian gnomes, the Norwegian Nisse. But not this year. But I collect angels. And as the weeks lead up to Christmas now, there will be more and more angels around in our house. And every year it makes me start to reflect on, do I believe in angels? And yes, obviously I do. I'm a Christian. I read the Bible. The Bible talks about angels. But what do the angels mean to me in my everyday life? It's hard to say, actually. Are they here? Are they here to... What are they for? Of course, there was an angel who came to St. Mary, to Maria, who used the word Maria for Mary in Norwegian. Telling her that she was to be the mother of Jesus. And you can find angels in art. They're very popular in old art, I think. But in my daily life, what does the angels mean? It's really hard to tell. I have an episode from last year, episode 19 in December 2020. I will try to remember to put a link to that episode down here, and then you can go back and see what I said about angels last year. I have been going through them and listening to the Norwegian episode from that day, but I'm not quite sure what I say in the English one because I haven't gone back to check that. But if you're interested, you can do that. Ariel, where are you? Here you are. She, as I said yesterday, she has been very busy because she has the eternity to take time from. But she came to me yesterday to tell a few more tales from this story I'm sharing with you. Again, unfortunately, it was in Norwegian, but I will try to tell it to you. They had been playing hide and seek yesterday, and Ariel was so tired. Oh, I'm worn out. And she flew in some beautiful corkscrew flying down to the lake. And Ariel, he came with her. Not as elegant as Ariel, so, but much faster. So it was a big splash when he landed, and they both were wet, but it wasn't good because they were so warm after the playing. They had been playing the whole afternoon. Now darkness was starting to fall. Well, that was down by the lake. Up in the sky, the sun was still there, but down by the lake, darkness was starting to fall. And the two angel children found themselves a comfortable way to sit just over the water mirror, just high enough so they wouldn't be wet, but still low enough so they could put their toes in the water and splash water on each other's. And then Ariel says, Ariel, do you know why they call the big star you found for the Bethlehem star? She was not going to tell Ariel her secret, but she was so curious. But Ariel, he had no time to listen. He had seen some other angel children over at the other side of the lake. So he, with a big splash, he flew over to them. So that was the fourth tale in the angel choir tale about Ariel. And Ariel and the other angels. I do have a nativity to show you today. Of course I have. This is a very special one, a very elegant one. But it has no angels. It should have today, of course, but this is the one I found. I bought it on Tenerife, on the Canary Islands, many years ago. Joseph, Mary as Queen Mary, and the smiling baby Jesus. So I'm going to put it up on the shelf down in the living room today. Okay, hopefully I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye.